بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين إن شاء الله I will read a hadith on a weekly basis إن شاء الله and I will point out some benefits about the hadith وبسم الله نبدأ عن عبادة ابن الصامت رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من شهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله وأن عيسى عبد الله ورسوله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه والجنة حق والنار حق أدخله الله الجنة على ما كان عليه من عمل هذا الحديث متفق عليه The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said Who bears witness Now he's going to mention a lot of things Who bears witness that There is no deity but Allah and does not associate anything with Allah and that Muhammad is his slave and messenger and that Isa, Jesus, is the slave of Allah and his messenger and that he is a word sent to Maryam, his mother and the spirit from him and Jannah, paradise, is true and the hellfire is true Allah will reward him with Jannah, with paradise on whatever act he is on. In this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, من شهد أن لا إله إلا الله, who bears witness that there is no deity but Allah. Now the word deity means something that is worship or one that is worshipped, al-ma'bud. Huh? So in this world today, are there any things that are worshipped? Of course there is, right? There's a lot of things that are worshipped. People worship animals, people worship other people that are alive, people worship things, people worship many things. Yeah? So, in the statement, the part of the declaration of Islam, al-Shahada, we say, La ilaha illallah. This word, this statement, has two pillars. The first pillar is nafi. Nafi means rejection. What do we reject? We reject all deities, right? We reject all, La ilaha, there's no deity. Okay? And then we confirm that second pillar is confirmation, ithbat. Ithbat to what? Ithbat there is only one deity that is worth worshiping. One deity that is worth worshiping. La ilaha illallah. Now, in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also talked about Isa, Jesus, the messenger of Allah. And he said, wa Isa abdullahi wa rasuluh. And Jesus is the slave of Allah. He's not his son, he's not a part or a member of his family. Allah does not have a family. No wife and no son. Yeah? So, wa Isa, Jesus is the slave of Allah and his messenger. Wa kalimatuhu, and a word sent to Maryam. What does that mean? A word sent to Maryam because Jesus was born without a father. It's a miracle. His birth is a miracle. And miracles are things that are illogical to us. We don't understand it. We can't scientifically prove it or understand it. So it was a miracle because he did not have a father. So Jesus, Allah Azza wa Jal, in the birth of Jesus, Allah said, Be kun, and he became fakan. And this is what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in the hadith, what he means. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, وَرُوحٌ مِنْهُ And a soul from him, or a spirit from him. And now, what does that mean? Does that mean the spirit, or Jesus, his spirit is a part of Allah? No, that's not what it means. You can sometimes mention things, attach it, or names or labels, attach it, names of creations, attach it to the name of Allah. I'll give you an example. Like we say to masjids, Mosques, what do we say? What do we call them sometimes? There's a name for them. We call them Baytullah. Baytullah, the house of Allah. Does that mean Allah lives in it? No. When we say Amatullah, a slave or a female slave of Allah, or we say Abdullah, okay? These are things that are mentioned or attached to the name of Allah as an honor, Tashrif, wa ijlal, or Tashrif, okay? So it's honoring to mention a name of a creation to the name of the creator. Okay? So this is not considered shirk, polytheism, or anything like that. Yeah? So this is what he means, وَرُوحٌ مِنْهُ It's a soul that came from Allah. Okay, it's not part of Allah. هذا ما عندي والله أعلم وصلي اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.